Hi, let's talk about the arteries of the pelvis and lower limbs. As you may recall, the abdominal aorta splits into the common iliac arteries at about the level of L4. Those common iliac arteries are going to ride the ridge of the division between the abdominal cavity and the pelvic cavity before dividing into the external iliac and internal iliac arteries. The external iliac artery is destined to exit the pelvis and become the femoral artery, and that transition point is the inguinal ligament. So after it passes underneath the inguinal ligament, that external iliac artery becomes the femoral artery, and we'll pick that back up in a moment. The internal iliac artery enters into the pelvic cavity, where it's going to supply the various pelvic viscera with blood, as well as the majority of the perineum. So let's look at that now. On the left side, sorry to be so binary here, we have a stereotypically female pelvis. On the right side, we have a stereotypically male pelvis. And let me give you the lay of the land in terms of some of the landmarks and viscera. So here we have the sacrum. You can see that here as well. Here's the rectum and the anal canal. Here's the pubic symphysis. Here are the urinary bladders. The ureter. Notice the ureter passes into the pelvis at approximately the branching of the internal iliac and the external iliac. Here it is over here. Also, there's the internal, the external iliac. So in that vicinity. And additionally, we have the uterus and vagina and a seminal vesicle. So let's take a look at the major divisions of the internal iliac, of which there are two. Probably the easiest, or at least the most straightforward, will be the posterior division. So I can see that posterior division right there. Here's the posterior division here. The posterior division supplies the body wall of the pelvis and hip through several branches. So the first is typically the iliolumbar, and in this case the iliolumbar is coming off of the internal iliac before it splits into divisions. That's ascending up out of the pelvis. Then we have typically two lateral sacral arteries. These lateral sacral arteries are going to travel through the sacral foramina to supply the wall of the pelvis posteriorly. And then the terminal branch is the superior gluteal artery. The superior gluteal artery is going to supply some of the muscles of the hip, and its name is a reference to how that artery exits the pelvis into the hip region. It is superior to the piriformis muscle. You'll notice there is also an inferior gluteal artery from the anterior division, and that's because that artery exits into the hip from the pelvis inferior to the piriformis muscle. Then we have our anterior division. Our anterior division, it's probably worthy of note that many of these branches are named for their targets. And so if you can see where they're going, you can oftentimes get a positive ID for what they are. Let's just work our way through. One of the first major branches is the umbilical artery. The umbilical artery heads out to the anterior body wall and typically throws superior vesicle branches. Those superior vesicle branches or arteries are supplying the urinary bladder with blood. When the umbilical artery gets to the abdominal wall, it is obliterated and turns into the medial umbilical ligament. And that medial umbilical ligament is going to travel up to the belly button, the umbilicus. It would have been the full pathway of the umbilical artery out to the umbilical cord in a fetus, but after birth, there's no need to send blood up through there because there's no return of blood to the placenta. Hence, you know, the obliteration of the artery at that stage. The next major artery is the obturator artery. The obturator artery is actually heading out of the pelvis through the obturator canal, and it's going to be part of the blood supply to the medial thigh, so the adductor compartment of the thigh. The next set of arteries are really named for their targets, and what's sometimes challenging is that many of these arteries will have branches that also supply adjacent viscera. So over here we see that there's a common trunk that's branching into the uterine artery and a vaginal artery. So the uterine artery is actually, I'm going to erase some of this so that we can see it more clearly. I want you to pay attention to the ureter coming down here. The uterine artery at about the level of the internal os of the uterus is going to cross over the ureter. That relationship there is immortalized in the mnemonic water under the bridge, with the uterine artery as the bridge and the ureter as the water. That's so that an OB-GYN can understand those relationships very quickly and easily so that they don't ligate the ureter during a hysterectomy. Then we have a large trunk here, and this is going to be the median rectal artery, which is not on this list, going down to supply the rectum. You can also see that there. And coming from this is the vaginal artery and possibly an inferior vesicle branch there. We can see an inferior vesicle branch coming off that median rectal artery or middle rectal artery there. So sorry about that. That's the middle rectal. So I'll just add that to the list. And then we have really the terminal branches of the internal iliac, the internal pudendal and the inferior gluteal arteries. So there's the inferior gluteal and the internal pudendal. The inferior gluteal artery is going out to supply blood to the hip. The internal pudendal artery is going off to be the dominant blood supply to the perineum. So now let's look to see the pathway of the external iliac artery. So with the external iliac artery, we can see the division between internal and external. As we pass under the inguinal ligament there, it becomes the femoral artery. And that's going to be in a region known as the femoral triangle. So we can see there's the femoral nerve there, the artery, and the vein. Excuse me. And deep within that triangle, the femoral artery is going to give off the deep artery of the thigh, oftentimes referred to as the deep femoral. And then the femoral will continue on. That femoral artery is going to supply, be the dominant supply to the anterior compartment of the thigh, as well as the medial compartment of the thigh, or the adductor compartment. And that adductor compartment is supplemented by that obturator artery from the anterior division of the internal iliac artery. Whereas the deep artery of the thigh is the blood supply to the posterior compartment of the thigh. So now we're looking at the popliteal fossa. It's been kind of dissected away here, so we can see all of the deepest contents. And within the popliteal fossa, we can see the tibial nerve. We can also see the popliteal vein and popliteal artery. And the popliteal artery is going to be the deepest structure within the popliteal fossa, which makes for obtaining a pulse at this point very difficult, but still possible. So that popliteal artery, which is just the continuation of the femoral artery as it exits from the adductor hiatus, continues on down through the popliteal fossa, and it's going to turn into the posterior tibial artery. So there's coming down. And that posterior tibial artery gives off a fibular artery. The fibular artery is going to be a supplemental blood supply to the lateral compartment of the leg. And that posterior tibial artery will continue inferiorly and be the dominant blood supply to the posterior compartment of the leg. At about the level of the calcaneus, we can't see it here, it's actually going to divide into a medial and a lateral plantar artery. That lateral plantar artery is going to be a large contributor to the plantar arterial arch. And it's going to anastomose with a deep plantar artery, which we'll talk about shortly, that is a continuation from the anterior tibial artery. So let's look at that now. So here we're looking at an anterior view of the leg. So there is the knee there, and coming down we can see the anterior tibial artery. That anterior tibial artery is the dominant blood supply to the anterior compartment of the leg, as well as the lateral compartment of the leg. So it's supplemented by that fibular artery from the posterior tibial. And as we transition down into the foot, that anterior tibial artery becomes the dorsalis pedis artery. And so we have an opportunity for a pulse palpation point. And then the dorsalis pedis artery dives deeply into the substance of the foot, and it is going to contribute to the deep plantar artery. That deep plantar artery is what helps to give rise to the plantar arterial arch. And as you recall, the other main substantive conduit to that arterial arch is the lateral plantar artery coming from the posterior tibial artery. So that is the major flow of blood between the pelvis and the lower limbs. We have external and internal iliac arteries coming from the common iliac. Internal serves the pelvis and has a posterior and an anterior division. Posterior is predominantly body wall. Anterior is abdominal viscera as well as perineum. That external iliac artery becomes the femoral artery. At the inguinal ligament, the femoral artery divides into the deep femoral artery within the femoral triangle. That deep femoral artery supplies the posterior thigh, whereas the femoral artery supplies the anterior and middle compartments of the thigh. The femoral artery exiting from the adductor hiatus becomes the popliteal artery. The popliteal artery is going to continue down the posterior lower limb and in the leg becomes the posterior tibial artery. Posterior tibial artery supplies the posterior compartment of the leg. It gives off the fibular artery, which is a supplemental branch to the lateral leg. And that posterior tibial artery divides into medial and lateral plantar arteries. The lateral plantar artery supplies the plantar arterial arch. The anterior tibial artery is a branch of the popliteal artery, which supplies the anterior and lateral compartments of the leg. It becomes the dorsalis pedis artery in the foot. And when that dives into the substance of the foot, becomes the deep plantar artery. And that deep plantar artery anastomoses with the lateral plantar artery to form the plantar arterial arch. Thank you very much for your time.